Okay, so after the import-export of state data, now I need to focus on resources again. Right now, resources are still gathered from the root directory and by name, which is not exactly a long-term proposition. So one of the things I'm going to have to do is one of the import the data from a flexible system, such as basically from the actual same locations as this. So to begin with, I am going to need, for the moment, okay, I'm going to put something here, maybe, or because I need something like much like the search paths, but specifically for resources. Goes through like the directories of I'm going to need to keep the directories or the import paths of the dependencies as well as the current loaded whatever instead of discarding them. So I guess something along the lines of OECS as well. See, that's a pointer directly to that. I don't want a pointer to another thing. Unless I do like a standard pair or something like that. Okay. Right now, they're all paths. They won't be always, but for the moment, they are. So let's focus on the idea that we're always getting things from paths. And use that as a basis to get something done. Temporary group won't, but this will. So we'll have, like, a tuple type. Index generators first. Something like that for the moment. Okay, and then we have we'll do. Oh, this is not great, but Looks like client D is broken, so let me get that back up. There we go, and there we go. So add group. No, 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 no. This tuple is terrible. I should really put it in here as well. Change this up to be like faux ECS group data, group, or just group. Back when I was thinking of doing it that way. Okay, and then we'll have searching for resources. Realistically, actually, should I be loading resources at runtime? Should I just find all the specs when I'm loading everything else instead? So I don't have to do this. I mean, most probably, yes. Okay. Don't do this. Back up. Back these two up. I'm thinking too hard and trying to do it too much. I don't need this, all that stuff. What I really honestly do need is I just need to import it, all the resources at this time when I'm importing everything else, and do the search and resolve at that time. No, because I need it for imported resources, which are resources like image files or meshes, not for the definitions. Okay. Resource ID is a UN32. Okay, for the moment. It'll probably be modified with group stuff later. Okay. And we need like a search path. Now there's two types of search paths I'm going to have to be able to do. I need to search through the file system, and then I need to be able to search through the resource, the group archives like these, for images that are hidden in there. Unless there's an enforced bit. Okay, so the idea would be something like this, a function that'll be along the lines of if not integrity. Search through the group data archives. Return false, or return null, or something like that. If something could not be found. Something like that. This would be okay. For the moment, rather, what I can do is I'm going to do this. I'm going to add this. Because they are still file-based for the moment, I'll make my life a little bit easier for the moment. I'm guessing I don't actually include foe directly here. Can either reset this. Index search, that's still the same. Okay, now when we're doing state YAML import, where we set, when we're creating the new groups, we do that, and then we say, then we generate, I need to go in reverse order. A unique pointer. I already have that, so okay, so the resource search paths are, so that's the file system search paths, and I need to go through the resource ones specifically. They are considered separate. And they go in reverse order, which means they start with that. Then I need to go through four. Is there a way to do like a, there's a reverse iterator that has to be. C Okay, these are done in that order. Or, hold on. Reverses the order of the elements. Okay, so I can just do it this way instead. Just to keep it easy. This is part of algorithm. Doesn't match, does it? Oh, yes. Invalid. Oh, because I don't actually have the definition here. Actually close. I need to add that. These are statically linked again, aren't they? Need to remove that. Okay. Hold on. Did I? Ah, yeah, okay. Okay, let's go now. There we are. Okay, so data A, B, D, and E. Go down one. It's now reversed. E, D, B, A. Okay, so the order has been reversed. Get rid of that. Move that out. Okay. As long as we have that, we're now going to have the resource search path as well as the file system search paths. Now, let's get this into place. What did I? Yeah, it's a CPP. Okay. Okay. So if I have that, then I can go through, let's say, into resource. We're going to have to add something to the loader to say, you know, this is, or no, it'd be part of the import function, wouldn't it? Right now, the import function is just the YAML function given through as part of application when we're creating a resource loaders somewhere. Yeah, here. With nothing else around it. I guess I'm going to have to start doing something about that, won't I? No, it's got all these functions that go along with it, or parameters. Making it way more difficult than it has to be. Okay, let's start with something that's pretty high up. The vertex descriptor. So this one. Because it has a sub-resource we can work with. Or do I start high level or low level? Start high level. So it has all these types. Okay. Okay. Like these are all the items that are required to actually create one of these, right? To a point. Those, well, for the moment, yes. Okay. If we go down here, we can then we'll create a like of that. To basically be all these things for the moment. And then we can change this out to be, you know, this. CreateInfo. That's the stuff that we want. We include it from the vertex descriptor, yes. And then the same thing on the vertex descriptor loader. It changes into this. No, not that. It's an and. Okay. Okay. We'll read vertex descriptor. Maybe the other way around. Leave that as it is and change this to be the type instead. Okay, we flip back to loader. Because down here, we're going to have to change all this for this. Pass that in instead. Trash these. And then it becomes CreateInfo dot. Right. Nope. 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 Not working. That's unfortunate. I wonder why. I mean, it looks all right. But doing this just kind of screwed it up. Okay, it's reset these, right? So try it again. Oh no, I just did I break it or something? Am I hold what? Did I modify something I shouldn't have down here? Did I screw this up? Shader, a shader, okay. No state data found. Da, 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 da. Attempted to export state via YAML to an existing directory. Oh, but that's afterwards. Sphere tower is the same. Non-bone mesh. Mesh material. Test mesh. Test mesh. Yeah. Okay, great. I don't know how I broke it, but I managed to break it. Something somewhere went wrong. And it can't have been from this. Must have accidentally modified one of these other files. Like application's not modified. That's the same. It's okay, let's go to the drawing point and see if we can find what exactly is going on. So is this XR? No, this is the one. Okay. We're only skipping draw for the one when it's supposedly loading everything. Then we're going through. Okay, I need to call in the render doc. Vertices, buffer zero, view the contents. Not entirely sure what the hell's going on with that. Which buffer was this? Okay, what if. Let's turn bones off for the moment, shall we? I'm just getting nothing. Nothing at all. Oh man. Okay. Render doc just crash. Not cool. Yeah, okay, render doc's crashing now as well. Fantastic. Okay, I'm going to have to take this offline to figure out what the hell's going on. Cheers. Okay, well, I didn't manage to fix the bone, but I managed to fix the non-boned by changing the vertex descriptor, which is another thing I've got to. So at least I can draw something, and I know if I screw something up real bad, that. So now I got to redo what I did for the vertex descriptor a moment ago, and then wiped out in the in a slight panic. So let's get the loader back, shall we? Put it over here. Close those to the right. Okay. No. Is it from here? Yes. Okay, so let's start at the very top, I guess. Yeah. Change that. We then change this. That's still the same for the moment. Go down to, or up to the loader header. Change this to be, That. Okay, and then that just leaves the loader then. We need to modify that. And all the way down there, here we need to... That. Clear all that out. This is all still string based, yeah. Okay, please work. Yes. Okay. So, did I even have to make a modification here? I don't think so. Okay, then let's do the next one. Shader takes in these types. So, do. I go to here. Okay, check for shader. All right, shader's done. This is actually kind of like a side thing, isn't it? Oh, that's just already got a create info type thing going on. Okay. Material. Okay. We got a loader. Not mesh loader, sorry. Material loader. Okay, is there everything for material? Nope. Ah, yes. image name. Oh, it's just image. And it's just fragment shader name instead. Not quite. I need a this. The entire idea behind the simplification is that rather than having to create a function that takes in all the various types, I can just pass in just a empty struct declaration, as long as it's a pointer or a reference like this. Make things way easier to do it. I need to do these first, just in case anyone was wondering what. Why? What's this? Yeah, okay. And double check that it works. Okay. Now we need to do image. Maybe, I mean, it's just a string. Armature has got something actually more interesting to do. But we really should do it on our image anyways, even if it is just that. Maybe, no, because this is an imported type, so I'm not really entirely sure on how that would work. I mean, technically armature would be the same as well, wouldn't it? Did I do it on mesh? No. Mesh, armature, and image are ones that would be imported from raw files, most probably, rather than resource data that's kept defined in line. So, should probably just, we have these, we'll start with these and get these done. Then we'll move on to the others. So just, some modifications for formatting. Okay, cute. This doesn't even matter, really. Simplified. Okay. Just make sure everything's good. Now that after that I've committed it, of course. Now that we've simplified a bunch of the functions, now I need to go back into down here. Okay, way down, too far down. Okay, around here, vertex descriptor is the one I was going to start. I needed to kind of expand this import function a little bit. Because right now, what does it do? It takes in the name and then the create info. Name is a string view. That's a reference. And then I have to figure out where this is based on the loader types I have available to me. And then I have to delegate it down, I think. Okay, so let's just say it's a bool, right? Does it? It should. Because that's what this does, right? Yeah, it returns a bool. And how would I tie this into the resource search? Which I don't even have anymore, actually. That's just an empty file. Okay, cool. It's gone. Now I need to find it. Where could it be? Would I need to register, like, register loaders, register importers. All right, but for now, we only have YAML, so let's just focus on that. We're just looking for ECS, that could be a reference, right? And here we go, like ECS groups dot that. Something like that. Hmm. Realistically, I should just do this. Right now, ECS groups is actually, I don't actually have any data. So what I'm going to do, that's for temporary search paths. So I need to actually add another one in here. Permanent search paths equals. I'm just going to place this for the moment. Actually, no, don't. Just an empty thing. Just the root directory, so at least I can keep getting the stuff I already have at the moment. Then a release writer. And set this. Okay. Come back down here. We have the reader, then we've got to go through. If exists iterator slash was it SV .yaml, something like that. Okay, fine. And then I want to change that to the path. The path of the file. Is regular file. Then I'd return this. Something like that. Yeah. Okay. Oh no, not SV. I need to pass in the path. Not the string view, the actual path of the file. Yeah. Actually, no, this isn't going to work, is it? Right now it's still SV, so that's just going to fail. Hard. Bad file, yeah. YAML bad file. Okay. And I guess I need to add YAML bad file to this. But for the moment. Okay, some modifications to that. Anyways, going back to application, just passing in SV, let's see how that goes. nothing loads. Really, that's the explanation? It's just bad file? Well, thanks. All right. I'm gonna stage that. I want to stage these others. Stage those, right? Not. Why are you deleting this file? Stop it. Stop deleting the thing I want. Stage that. Okay. For the moment, that does seem like it would probably be okay to work. To my mind. Okay. I'm gonna leave it there for the moment and think on this. I don't want to make any rash decisions quite yet. Because this is a lot closer, but this doesn't quite feel right yet. So cheers. Okay. With some more modifications to the others to kind of follow the same kind of strange search pattern, I suppose. One thing. Okay, first of all, let's see if it actually works. Let's actually distribute some of these items around. So let's say the boned mesh VD goes into group A. Let's just put it in the root directory right there. Resources this. And let's say we don't emplace back that, we emplace back. Let's do that, shall we? Yeah, let's just star that, right? Full search pattern. Oh my god. Okay. Back up. While I flounder around, we're going to do it this way. We're going to do data state the data A. B, C, wait, hold on. What are the dependencies I have? A, B, and D. Okay. Okay. Not great. ABD. Okay. And let's put something into here. We already have bone that. What do we have here? We need this to be copied and placed into here. We'll put non-boned mesh VD into group B. Come on, B here. And then we put the last two vertex descriptors into E. Let's just let's get rid of output test data state measure of output test. Okay. That'll make things a little bit easier, right? Get rid of a few files. Make things a bit more easier. Okay, let's try this. I just moved the vertex descriptors. They should all be part of on the paths. So and this means that basically nothing else will be. For material, oh, the vertex descriptors are still missing, actually. That did not work at all. Great. Okay. Let's have a look. Wherever I put the vertex descriptor one. There it is. Let's see. Paths, what we got? Well, three paths, data, state A, state B, and state, ooh, yeah, okay. Right now we're not actually looking at the resources subdirectory, are we? Let's do that. Can we at least get, so yeah, now this time going 2 and 3. Only one of the vertex descriptors failed this time. Okay. Let's see if I can find out which one it was. Resource, libs, YAML, source. No, not libs, YAML, source, descriptor loader, failed, this one, with error, that. So which one are we? We are the vertex descriptor 2. Really, you couldn't find that one, which was sitting right here in the data E. Are you sure about that? Interesting. I would have figured it would be fine. Okay. Let's go through until we get it right. Let's see. Search file name is the vertex descriptor 2. .yaml. Okay, we have okay, this isn't what I'm looking for at all. Right now, you know what? They're all let's try it single. Like I need, okay, that's another thing I need to actually do. I need to add ability to turn off multi-threaded threading to figure out issues like that one. So what we were doing here, search file name was vertex descriptor 2.yaml. That's okay. So is it here? No, it shouldn't be. See here. B? No, it shouldn't be. D. Wait, hold on. Why did I add D? It should be E. Or, hold on. Okay, there is a D, and then there is an E. Of course, because after that, I need to actually check the local one, wouldn't I? Why, yes, of course. Okay, now it'll find everything at least. All the vertex descriptors, anyways. The only things are missing are shaders and fragment descriptors, and or it's just going to freeze on something. Don't know what. Interesting. What are you frozen on? Scoped lock of that. Who has the lock? You can't have the lock. You're waiting on something. You're waiting on something. This is Vulcan stuff. Vulcan. Okay. Interesting. Interesting. Why? I don't have it from here. Yep. This is why. Okay. I guess I have a problem somewhere dealing with that. So I'm going to have to figure that out sooner or later as well. That. Let's see if we can do the same thing for the others then. So, shader. Oh, we got an old file here. Whatever. Shader. These shaders go into E. Let's say for the moment. This shader and this shader. Goes into B. Yes. This shader goes into A. That leaves materials, so material. What? The rest of this just goes into frickin'. Just about here, right? Just goes into E for the moment. What else we got? Out state data. Out. Where is out? Out state data, you are gone. Let's see if that works. No. The answer is a resounding no. So, why? Armature and stuff is up here, right? Test armature is right there. And then the file name is cube tower and sphere tower, which are sitting right here at the moment. And same thing with image. Bad file. Oh, yeah. Okay. Armature, mesh, image. They haven't been moved over yet. Move back out here. Okay. Now, when I'm just trying to think. When I am importing, looking for a resource, do I know what the type it is? Actually, I should probably do that right now. I'm going to implement IDs on these damn things right freaking now. Index ID of 0. Ooh, actually, is it a resource? Is it going to follow with the ECS IDs or resource IDs? I gotta fall back to that idea. They're probably going to be separate. They're going to have to be. Okay, let's see what I can do about ECS IDs. Like, can I turn this into some kind of like generic type? Like right now, it's the number of group bits is 4. Okay. Damn it, whatever. Index 0, index 1. Then down here we'll have a bit of fun. Or no. There's so many things I'm trying to accomplish at once, and I keep messing up the order as to how I should really be doing these. What I should be doing is have some items, I import them, and then I should just re-export them. So, let's start with something that's high level. I think, or would it be low level? Higher level or lower level? You know what? Screw this. We're just going to shrink it all down. We'll start at lower level. Pretty sure. And then we can convert. No. High level. I'm sorry. I'm just such a mess on this stuff. I'm just so many things running through my mind. I can't really latch onto anything for long enough to really come up with a clear idea what I need to do. Okay, this is what's happening, okay? Gonna have an ID type just sitting here. We're just gonna call it We're not gonna bother with anything fancy right now. See standard int using info resource ID 32 T type. That's the type we're going to run with. And then when we get in here, we're going to pull that in. And then we're going to have a foo resource ID. And as part of that, down here, we're calling the vertex descriptor. We'll say, you know, we have a foo resource ID. And we're going to pass that through. Okay, then down on application, we're going to have this. It's going to be 0, 1, and 2. Or then we're going to update the pool to get this. To be able to find based on that instead. That it's going to be a function I'm going to need. Get that rolling back down here. Okay. Okay, so if we have these, then, okay, does that work, first of all? I mean, that should work. And then I'll just have to, like, pass in one when I'm searching for the vertex descriptor, which I want to use. Or, hold on. Finds number one. So that could work. Then I'm going to want to update the... Do I have an exporter for this? I should. Vertex descriptor, YAML export descriptor, yes. Which is currently based on just that, isn't it? see if I can find the exporters. Which I don't think I have any more. Initialize. Then I have here export. So now I need to get this. So I need to basically run like export YAML descriptor definition. And it'll be like vertex script pool find 0, 1, and 2. Okay. That and then we have these three again. Okay. And they're sitting in the root, right? Vertex descriptor, that. That. Can I actually. No, I can't. Do I not have comparisons? Partial diff? I do have partial diff. It's not available, or what? We just need to restart. Select for compare, and compare against the handwritten one in E. Bound mesh. VD, or is it sitting at A? Where is it? Now that is very interesting. That may explain why my okay. This is where I screwed up like earlier. I had that instead, didn't I? That's why my animation started screwing up. I'm gonna bet if I was to go back down here somewhere, or no, it's gone. Yeah, okay. Stride went to string. And that's why I started screwing up. Sorry? Is this the wrong one? Oh, this is the XR one. Whoops. Okay, here we go. There we go. Oh, yes, I fixed that earlier bug again. already?
Yes.
Okay, fix that up. Thank you. That should also mean that this is now basically the same.
Right.
This is... it's just capitalized instead, but same deal. Okay. Okay, I'm going to hard code the directory I'm saving this stuff to. This is initialization and export here. Ooh, I don't actually. Yeah, okay. So that's not quite going to work quite yet. So what I would do want to do then, go into the source, and it's going to be like something underscore some. Yeah, it's going to be something underscore something. Yeah. So the path.native import exports here. Okay. Get name plus .yaml, so it's going to be like of the p for descriptor good ID plus that, well rather plus an underscore, I think makes the most sense. Plus the name .yaml. Okay, great. And then down here, 012. Okay. Okay, so that's probably something I'm going to want to do then, starting very soon, is to start exporting all the resources. But for the moment, we'll keep it like this. So let's do that. Let's at least clear all those out. Let's just do this. So we're going to like that. Bam. What's this? Ooh, yeah. Oh no, we'll just do these ones. Let's go to the ID. Then we're going to add vertex descriptor stuff. These guys, thank you. And then we're going to add the update to application. If I can read, there we go.
this material. Okay, do we necessarily want to do this part yet? Probably not. Revert that part. Unstage that bit. Keeping that. YAML, not quite, not yet. Stage that part. Two resource types. Let's just add it to this one. Just do one at a time. Leave it like that. Simple. Because it's not really quite there yet. So what I'm going to do, though, is from here, I'm going to open the actual file. Thank you. And what I am going to grab out is... No, not really. Okay, next. Material's fairly high up, so we'll take that one next. Okay. Include that. So, okay, it's just close a lot of things. Close others. Material.cpp, and we need the get ID as well. Calling function. Here we are. Okay, we're going to do the same thing on the material loader, or pool, I should say. Need to find things by ID instead. ID. If it equals that ID, okay, great.
Okay, material public. When we're exporting the definition, it's now that. It's now that instead. And then over here in the application. We're gonna export these guys. So how many materials do we have? We have 1, 2, 3. So we already have 0, 1, 2, so we need 3, 4. And 5. Probably something very wrong going on in here. Okay, what we've got? Yes. Okay, we exit, then we've got a whole bunch of things. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So let's compare this, the material with the material up here. It's just the same. Okay, so I got a good import-export going on. So we got that. We got that. We don't have that yet. Not that either. We have this. That's also something I actually have to add, is the fact that it'll also be exporting. Okay, let's undo the last commit. And undo the commit before that as well. Or maybe not, not yet. So I need to go back into material and vertex descriptor public. First of all, I need to write out the index, so. Index ID equals P vertex descriptor get ID.
And then we do the same thing for here. Which would actually be inside of here somewhere instead. Get ID, that. So what part of this? Yes and yes, we're adding these. And then we're adding the materials. But not the conversion of the import yet. Yeah, what fun. So what we got down here, we got 0, index ID is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, looking good. Okay. The next interesting one will be... I'm just so scattered. Close these guys. Shader? Yeah, let's do shader. Going to go down here. We're going to have a so back up to shader, we need the get ID function. Okay. Templating of the basics probably would have been useful right here. Oh well. Later. I'll figure it out later. Okay, here we go. This is the interesting part. Because it's a subtype, and I don't actually load these guys in myself. I think. Do I? VD, mesh armature. No, I don't. I actually don't bring in shaders myself. That means right now these shaders are all going to be like... it's like a 0 or something. Mm-hmm. These are all created here via 999. Because CreateInfo.vertex shader is expecting that instead. And 999 here as well. Okay, so if I was to export all the shaders right now at the end of the application cycle, they're all going to be 999. But let's just do it regardless, shall we? Can I not? Oh, I can't, actually. They're all sitting at 9999. I don't really have a good function for just going through the pool right now. But I will in a second, because I'm just going to add it. Whatever. Okay, we're just going to get the entries, and we're just going to return mshaders. There ain't nothing you're going to do about it. It's part of the... Where is it? Down here, right? Yeah. Entries, wonderful. We're going to go through them. Okay. Let's see what we get for this. I'm sure this will be super fun and fantastic. I actually do save the spur v source. But I'm not saving the index ID for one. That should fix a little index ID problem right there. Still good. Okay, we're at least writing it out. So now I need to kind of start modifying. I need to make these individual numbers now. I really do. So this will be like number 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Okay. You can move these up here. All the way up to E, right about here. And now we get the super fun part of finding where the hell all these guys come from. So what's going to happen is we need to change from using strings to using the numbers. So one part of this is going to have to be, I'm going to have to change how I search, obviously, since I don't actually have the strings available to me anymore. So that's actually one thing I'm going to have to do. These shaders need to be changed from right shader declaration, which was what that. Change the shader declaration here. This is not the git name, it's the git ID. Okay. Wow, see, this is why. Do I have a read shader definition? I do. Well, that's a declaration. I don't have writing declarations, which I honestly probably should have. Well, that's writing. Okay, vertex descriptor. When we're writing, these are going to write out strings or... Let's just actually have a look. Bam. So, vertex descriptor, vertex shader 999999999. Good. Kind of. Rather, have a look. Vertex descriptor. Let's make sure all the vertex descriptors and stuff are all together. Boned mesh vert shader is now number 6. Okay, actually, before we do this, let's add everything. Okay. Whatever happens now. Import. Read vertex descriptor definition. That's actually one thing that needs to be changed right now is the vertex descriptor up here. These are now that. Okay. So then we go into vertex descriptor, public, reading, or writing these things. These are now dap, bap, bap, bap. Okay. Read optional, it's an int. Yeah, okay. So now they're bringing them in as ints. So that's kind of okay. No, that's also something I probably want to do as well, actually, while I'm at it. I'd also want to read out the editor name, I guess we'll call it. It should be like bone mesh vert shader. Human readable editor name, which isn't used in the main application, but it is used. The shader. Cause so many variables. Name. This is, I should have started on the lower level. I should have. A single albedo shader. That's the editor name, which we get from the definition when reading it in. Yeah, I really should have done this in a different way, in a different order. Oh well. Oh well. That's how it all kind of falls apart. So now what I'm looking for is when I'm looking. So we've got these. The shader 2, shader 3, the descriptor, descriptor. Okay, when I'm loading. Loader. It's now this. That's not great. That's not great at all. In fact, that's kind of worse. Now I'm super screwed. I got myself into an unwinnable position. Damn it. Dang. Dang it, dang it, dang it. Okay. As part of the loading mechanism, okay.
Let's reverse these for the moment. Make sure I'm still in a stable state where I can work right now. Correct? Oh my god, how long is this? Do I have like nanometer running in the background? No, I don't. Okay. Okay, that's something I can do though right now. Is I can get that out of the way. I can get the like the editor names printed out to these things at least. So we have the index ID. Shader. Material. Basically same thing here, except we don't have that yet. Wait, that's reading. Writing an image declaration. Oh, I don't have even like writing definition yet for this. Do I? No. What about this? Nope, not for this either. Ugh. Okay, well, let's at least make sure that at the moment, what I'm going to print out to nowhere because it doesn't even compile. Acquired here. Yeah, I forgot about that. Probably should have completed a lot more of this before. I decided to split them out to files and get them from files again. You live and learn. Okay. 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 What I'm going to have to do is a bit of a bit of funky business here. I'm going to have to actually forward declare these shaders now before I can actually use them in the application. That could work. It's going to be terrible, but it's going to work. That's what matters. So we go to wherever we had initialized all the resources. It should be somewhere in here. Come on. Here we are. So what's going to happen is we're going to start forward declaring these guys. Okay. It's going to be, let's go down here, or actually rather up here. 6. Boned mesh vert shader. Shader loader. The shader. And then we just got to do this a few more times. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And then finally 11. Okay, if these are all four declared, then I don't actually need to do anything. And then these guys will pop right back out as with their correct IDs and stuff. Okay, 6 through 11, that's great. So we pass, we get rid of these guys. No longer required. So we'll do add these. And then we move these guys over just to see what happens. Make sure. Cut. And we paste them up here. Okay, we'll just move them manually then. Come on. Up, 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 up. Up to here. Replace them. Okay, let's see what we've got. Did I not already have these guys up here, or what? I guess not. Okay. Whatever, right? They still work. I hope to God they still work. Okay, seemingly they do. Okay, now that means I can update the loading function to search when it searches for shaders and stuff. Now it's not necessarily this, it's string view. Ooh. If I was to update this to shaders are all this. So now it's going to be something different, like faux resource ID, and it's going to be something along the lines of the starting value up to the underscore will always be that. So one thing I may have to do because I don't know precisely how to organize it. These would be organized. This is brutal. Okay, but this is something I do need to have, is the shader needs to start accepting. Shader loader needs to accept. Okay. Which means I'm going to have to start enforcing a very particular naming scheme for the files, which I guess I'll do. I will do it. So it's changing. It's going to be, actually, I need to do it. I need to do a directory search because directory search import. Goes in here. And I need to do a recursive directory iterator from the target group path, from the starting area, from the IT location. Ooh, this is going to be absolutely brutal, actually. Okay.
I mean, I could make my life easier and just use like the ID.yaml, but like that's easier up front. That'll be a lot harder in the long run. I should really sort out how to do this right now. Okay, so I need to go through each of these, and then if it's a regular file, oh, I could have just done that here as well. Cool. File, what's required? File path, file stem, what is this? File system, path, extension, what's the stem part? Bar. Stripped of its extension, so it should be stem. What is stem? Stem is a subpath, so I need a like dot C string of this. Find first of underscore. Article standard string end position. Beware. File stem equals of 0 up to this. So we have the numerical portion. So what I want to do is I want to do standard to int from string. Standard string to I. Unsigned long. Does this throw anything? change error occurs, and that is returned. If no conversion can be performed, zero is returned. Ooh. I don't like that. String to unsigned long actually does deal with hexadecimal by default, looks like. If it starts with a 0x, if it starts with a 0, well, that's confusing. Oh no, that's going to make it absolute hell, actually, for me to do. Actually, would it? Maybe. Okay, I guess I actually need to figure out a proper scheme. Proper naming scheme for all this nonsense. So, what's the naming scheme of entities and resources then? I'm going to need something that can deal with both. Perhaps I can do this by groups, like 0xe for the group, underscore, or dash, no, underscore, 0xe would be the index. So this will be the group ID, this will be the index ID, and then if it has an editor name, it will be a third one, or a third grouping of strings, blah, 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 blah. But YAML. That. Are there any exceptions that are going to throw this into disarray? Yes. Permanent, persistent entities that belong with this type. Because this type is special, so then we'll have like a persistent underscore 0xe for the index, because the group ID that's currently like sitting at like E or F can be changed. Like if I decide to change the number of bits assigned to the group, then is then like this group should technically be like 0xff instead. So I can't use that for the technically the floating group, so it has to be something special like a P in this case for persistent. And then I have the string, so I can do this, which has two sets, two groups. So I have two cases, persistent and a dependent type or a group from a dependent group. Or can I just have an underscore? If it's just nothing. Ah, that actually may be better. If it's just a plain old underscore, that'll move to the front of the file system. It'll probably be the item I'm really looking for anyways. That would make more sense. Because I think I kind of had that for the out. The one I had, which was p-something, which is kind of not great. So this should actually deal with all my issues, with my current issues mostly. So let's figure this out. Okay. Which also does imply that resource ID is going to follow the same group pattern as well.
I don't have an index mechanism for those resources yet. But I guess I'm going to have it soon. After I do this. So. Persistent type. Entry.path.stem. Bam. Group stem equals dir entry, rather full stem. Find first of that. That's a bad case. Else, actually, we'll just kind of like not even have an else. It'll just be regular. Then we have to go auto stem end. Okay, how many types do we have? That starting index of character to start to search from. Okay, yes, that's what I'm looking for. It starts from first stem end. We fail. Then that's actually not too bad, because then that at least means okay, no, that's actually, that's still a good case. That just means it goes to the end of the string. Right, and if I go back to strings, basic string, go to substring, if I give substring with a end position, it's nothing, right? End position, then it goes to the end of the string anyway. So then we're good from there, okay.
Let's see how this goes. I'll make sure my logic is not terrible. Ah, good. We actually just failed out somewhere anyways. So where are we? Resource, function handler. No, here, no, here. Okay, we called this. I'm in here somewhere, presumably. Yes. Data state the data the resources. Is there really not a... I mean, yes. Okay. Something I'll have to fix up. Along with so many other items. Okay, we get the full stem. Okay, it's just dying because it's not. It's trying to do things out of order. Let's do this synchronously, shall we? Our job's a little bit easier. The vertex descriptor. Just continue. It's not a valid thing, so just continue. Okay, go away. Great. There is shader 3. What? Okay, now we're at 9, the shader, right? Okay. Hold on, is this just really like first stem end? It's group stem. This becomes 9. The index stem becomes. Okay, can I get this done properly then? Compilation time's really starting to slow down with this one. So the full stem was 2 boned mesh VD. The group stem was 2. Second stem was the rest of it. Okay. I need to start fixing that up, obviously. Get rid of that, get rid of that. Okay. One non-boned mesh. First stem is basically zero, so group stem it comes empty, so it's the local thing. The second stem end is two. Index stem becomes this. That means technically for the rest of the stem would become like substring starting at second stem end and goes to the rest of the thing plus one. If it had it that I really cared about. No, that's going to be problematic, isn't it? Non-bone mesh VD. Index stem becomes that. 2 minus 0. Substring is what? Length of the substring. Plus and minuses all over the place. That's actually one too many. Oh, yeah. I already added it. This also means I also need to validate that the files I'm pulling in are the correct types. One non-boned mesh. Okay, let's see if we got the 0, 0. How does that work? One,
whatever.
For why am I coming through twice?
That's probably just a quirk of the debugger. 0, 0, the vertex descriptor. Okay. If we did find it, so we can get scrap that. So we have the group, we have the index, we can smash these together and then figure out equals standard string to ULL, I think it was. That's what I was looking at. Backup string to ULL from C standard lib. Takes in the const char of the string to the end. Wait, what's... Do I have to actually say what the end of the string is? I don't understand. An end. Oh, okay. So, I don't understand. Does this not return errors? Unless it's zero, which it might.
currently base of 0. Let's go with that. What is this? Group stem was empty. Oh, yeah, okay. Do I have an M? Okay, now if index equals the ID that we were given in the first place, then we want to do this. We already know it's a regular file, right? Yeah, it's the only reason we're in here, and that it exists because it's an entry there. So return that. We return the dir entry. Wow, all that. Ten, the shader 3, we're looking for number 10, which was the shader 3, correct. 9 for the shader. 8 for the non-boned vert shader. Yeah, okay. So basically, we're good on this again. Not quite, though. Whoops. Diddly doodly. So not quite, I guess. Unless it's something to do with the fact that I'm loading them synchronously again.
Okay. So, which one are we talking about? Talking about the boned mesh vertex descriptor. Okay. He's using this. Select for compare. Boned mesh vert shader. We're going to compare against this guy. Oh, that's a lot of fun. They're all literally using the same shader. Okay. I'm not saving these properly, of course. Okay. There we go. We're going to have to fix this. These guys. So boned mesh vert shader goes along with this guy, and he actually accepts or takes in this. Or hold on, no. That's a type right there. Secondarily, wait, hold on. Don't save. This guy. Takes in that. Mesh frag shader. Okay, he's the same. Non-boned mesh vert shader does not obviously take that. Supposed to take in that. Shader 3, the shader takes in that, which also takes in that. Okay, that's fine. Shader 3, UV color. Shader 3 is supposed to take in that. Single albedo shader. Supposed to take that in instead. Okay. Now, with those guys changed over, now I need to change over the material and the vertex descriptor to provide the number instead of the string name. So, we've got this all staged. Yes, we do. Next stage of this monstrosity. Okay, we got these guys. So passing that in. This goes into there, vertex descriptor. Okay, it goes into here, okay.
These become the new string type. Whoops. That instead. Shader declaration now becomes the get ID instead, which is correct. Change that one. That one and that one and that one and that one and that one. So actually, I should be able to just move these guys right over. Almost move them over. So 1 through 5. So I'm going to scrap those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now they should load incorrectly. Actually, at the same time, I should move over these others. Really should be. That. Shader public. That. Material public. That. If I come through here, now it's going to be swapped over, so it's going to be looking for that instead. Should be temporary. Oh, crap. I need an invalid type. Yeah, we'll do that. If it's not equal to that. I mean, technically, making my life a lot harder if I don't use zero as a null type or an invalid type, aren't I? But that would mean necessarily mean that if I'd have to like disable zero for index arrays. No, I'm not going to do that. No. Or would I maybe? Could I keep group zero then? I could maybe keep group zero. No, I wouldn't be able to keep group zero. Because then that would become the invalid group as well. Okay, that's just how it's going to have to be. So that, and we do the same thing on material loader, I believe. Also need to do that here. Material. Shader name, frag descriptor. Would also be changed over soon. Actually, it's already brought in from that. CPP. Shader pool find. I didn't implement that, did I? I guess not. We got problems. We got big problems. Very big problems. Vertex shader. Cannot parse map type node as that. Application. Where is this fun nonsense? Here it is. No, I don't really want to modify this yet. So just actually leave that there. And we're just going to have to bite the bullet and actually rename these things. Or probably fix them. Vertex descriptor 2. The shader 3 is number 10. Vertex descriptor 1. Takes in the shader 2, which I don't even use anymore. Single albedo shader. Boned mesh vert shader. 6. It's not part of this one yet. None boned is. Mesh shader 8. I did actually do the modifications for material, so we got to do that here. Mesh material, mesh frag shader 7. That four single albedo is 11 actually. That's a surprisingly okay result, actually. So let's see how these, if I move these up. There any real changes? minor changes. Oh, yes, the UV to color thing. They're printing out the wrong shader. Why? Don't know. Quite frankly, this has gone on for long enough, and I'm probably... Have I made okay progress? I think I've made okay progress. Even if it's not quite what I would have all totally wanted. 0 underscore 0. Get rid of that. Okay, now that I have those bits, I'll do just a little bit more. I'm just going to convert over this other thing for material. This is the shader. Actually, while I'm at it, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. No, actually, I'll complete shader. What I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the string from being part of the initial creation. So only the ID, really. The ID and the loader. And even the loader is probably going to go away soon. So then just all you need is just that. The ID and the loader. Great. That's it. That's all we care about. Instead, it'll be brought in as part of this for the moment. For the moment, it's not actually part of the requirement. It's not going to be required for creation of shaders, but I'll use it to pass it around for the moment. So. Maybe. Or not. No. It's just gone. No, I need the name to... You know what? No, I'm just going to call it there. I'm trying to do something I'm probably not mentally capable of right now. All right, I'm going to call it there. Cheers.